Dear friends, this is episode number 66 of the Limitation Act. We were dealing with Article 65 and Article 64 and 65 as well as adverse possession. Now, I stated the principles on the basis of which these contentions are to be dealt with, and I promise that I will cite a few decisions. I propose to cite many decisions. Why? Because the various interpretations, various shades of meaning, and therefore all those things become relevant. 2016 5 Kerala High Court cases 562 Thomas versus Lonappan and another. This I cited while dealing with section 27. Again, why this decision becomes important is a Supreme Court judgment in Gurudwara Sahib's case held that a person who has perfected title by adverse possession cannot maintain a suit for declaration, and he can use the adverse possession only as a shield and not as a sword. This was against very many decisions of the Supreme Court. In that case, there was a suit for injunction by the person in adverse possession, and that was decreed, and the Supreme Court and the trial court did not grant the decree for declaration on the ground that it cannot be used as a sword. Supreme Court upheld it ultimately and held that the adverse possessor can take it as a defense, the plea of adverse possession, if a suit is filed by the real owner. It was also held the finding that he has perfected title by adverse possession in a suit for injunction filed by him will operate as res judicata. What more is required? Everything found in favor of the person who has perfected title by adverse possession. At the same time, said he cannot maintain a suit for declaration against the true owner. That means he becomes remediless. After having perfected title by adverse possession, he becomes remediless. And let the real owner file a suit. Which real owner will file a suit? He will not file a suit. Because then he will lose. Who will file a suit? So that theory does not reflect a correct approach, and it was against the various decisions of the Supreme Court. So this question came up for consideration before Justice Hariprasad in Thomas versus Lonappan. A very detailed discussion. That is why this Kerala decision becomes important. This was before Grewal's case. Grewal's case, now there is no difficulty. And Gurudwara Sahib case was overruled. But this was rendered at a time when Grewal's case was not rendered by the Supreme Court. And I will read certain portions. A division bench of the Supreme Court consisting of three learned judges were of the definite view that there is no bar in filing a suit for recovery of possession based on a claim of prescriptive title acquired by adverse possession and limitation. When a suit for recovery of possession based on such title could be maintained, legally there can be no bar in instituting a suit for declaration of title. This is what is held in that decision. Therefore, I am clear in my mind that if a suit for recovery of possession based on prescriptive title acquired by adverse possession and limitation can be maintained. A suit for declaration of title and consequential reliefs can also be maintained for the above said legal logic. I find that a suit for declaration prescribed of title prescribed by adverse possession limitation is maintainable for the aforementioned reasons. It is sufficiently clear from the evidence that the contention of Grama Panchayat, etc., etc. Then about Gurudwara Sahib's case, it is the further submissions that this view expressed by two learned judges in Gurudwara Sahib's case is contrary to the law declared by a division bench of three learned judges of the Supreme Court in Sharangadeva, Periya Matam and another. Please note, Sharangadeva, Periya Matam and another versus Ramaswamy Gowdar. AER 1966 Supreme Court 1603. In the light of the argument, it has become so and so. For the aforesaid reasons, I am of the view that the decision in Sharangadeva's case has to be followed as a precedent in the light of the definite findings therein, contrary to the law laid down in Gurudwara Sahib's case. The opinion expressed in NSS case also fortifies my view. So that even before Grewal's judgment was pronounced by the Supreme Court, the Kerala High Court held that there is a three-judge bench decision in Sharangadeva Periyamadam, and that will govern the field. And Gurudwara Sahib of a lesser quorum, bench of lesser quorum, will not be binding. Now let us see what Gurudwara Sahib's case held. Then we come to the other. Yes, that is 2014 1 SCC 669 Gurudwara Sahib versus Grama Panchayat Village Sirthala SIRTHALA. Now, from the facts stated in this decision, it is clear that the adverse possessor had filed a suit for injunction against the real owner, and that suit was decreed. Then he filed a suit for a declaration against the real owner that he has perfected title by adverse possession, and therefore he is entitled to a declaration to that effect. But that was rejected, and Supreme Court also rejected it. We, however, find that this relief of declaration has been denied on the ground that suit for such a prayer was not maintainable, in as much as declaration to this effect on the basis of adverse possession cannot be sought, and the plea of adverse possession is available only as a defense to the defendant. Then in paragraph 9, this is in paragraph 3, in paragraph 9 it was held, as the appellant is in possession of the property since 1952 and has been granted a decree for injunction, it obviously means that the possession of the appellant cannot be disturbed except by due process of law. Supreme Court says in favor of the adverse possessor. We make it clear that though the suit of the appellant, that is adverse possessor, seeking relief of declaration has been dismissed, in case respondents file a suit for possession, respondents means real owners, and ejectment of the appellant, it would be open to the appellant to plead in defense that the appellant had become the owner of the property by adverse possession. Needless to mention, at this stage, the appellant shall also be at liberty to plead that the findings on issue number 1 to that effect, that the appellant is in possession of adverse possession since 1952, operates as res judicata. all the findings in favor of the person who has perfected title by adverse possession, but said, no, no, you are not entitled to get a declaratory decree. You are only entitled to use this as a shield. You can defend so long as the owner does not file, real owner does not file a suit against you. You cannot do anything. How can a person maintain that property in future? How can the revenue authorities or the whole world ascertain as to who is the owner? Suppose the true owner then transfers the property as if he is in possession. How can the purchaser be protected? Because the revenue records and the records in the registrar's office will show that he is the owner. So a third party will be duped. A purchaser will be duped. And how can this adverse possessor who has perfected title by adverse possession ventilate his grievance, show that he is the real owner before the authorities? Nothing. A decree for injunction. Shall he produce this decree for injunction before all? It is not possible. Suppose the real owner transfers, he has to meet the transferee and then say, I have got a decree for injunction. Res judicata, everything set in my favor. Can he go on doing it? Can he pay revenue? Can he get a possession certificate? Can he mortgage it in a bank? So that all the incidents of immobile property which are available to a normal title holder would be denied to him. And what happens if adverse possession is perfected? The real owner's title will be extinguished under Section 27 and that title will pass on to the adverse possessor. So thereafter, the person in adverse possession is the real owner. Which record will show that? If a declaratory decree is passed, it can be sent to the registrar's office. Necessary entries in the revenue record, in the records can be maintained. Records can be made. Or in the village office also, he can do it. Get mutation. Now he was denied all those things. Now comes another decision of the Kerala High Court, same judge, Justice Hari Prasad. That was also before Grewal's judgment. ILR 2018 to Kerala 399. KHC also, 2018 1 KHC 813. There, this Gurudwara Sahib cannot be relied on as a binding precedent, all those things held. Lonapan Thomas versus Lonapan was referred to. And a few sentences. If a person wrongfully keeps possession of a property with hostile animus against the title holder for the statutory fixed period, whatever title the original owner has in the property will be lost in favor of the person in wrongful possession. And after the lapse of time, it is right if one person loses title to a removal property, certainly another person should get it. The concept of res nullius, thing of no one, applies to an ownerless chattel and not to an immovable property. Title to immovable property can be lost in many ways. That is by operation of law and by act of parties. In the case of a person prescribing title by adverse possession and limitation, the wrongdoer who causes the extinction of the title gets the benefit by acquiring title. So long as Section 27 of the Limitation Act is vibrantly alive in the statute, no one can complain that the provision lacks morality. That point also dealt with. As laid down in many decisions, The section provides a substantive right. Title to property cannot be in a state of suspended animation. If one loses title, another one should get it, either by operation of law or by act of parties. Here, under Section 27 of the Limitation Act, the adverse possessor gets title with all the incidents thereof by prescription. This is what is held. Then, now we will go to Grewal's case. So, this is the background in which the Supreme Court, consisting of three judges, Justice Arun Mishra, Justice Abdul Nasir, and Justice M.R. Shah. Judgment authored by Justice Arun Mishra. A very detailed judgment. And once you read the judgment in full, you will get almost a good idea about what adverse possession is. The history is traced, the development of law is traced, and the principles are laid down. It is held in that Grewal's judgment, 2019-8 SEC, 729. Same as AIR 2019 Supreme Court, 3827. Ravinder Kaur Grewal and others versus Manjit Kaur and others. The statute does not define adverse possession. Nowhere you will get the definition of adverse possession. It is a common law concept. The period which has been prescribed statutorily under the Limitation Act as 12 years. Law of limitation does not define the concept of adverse possession. Nor anywhere contains a provision that the plaintiff cannot sue based on adverse possession. See, there is no bar in filing a suit. It only deals with the limitation to sue and extinguishment of rights. And once a person gets title, he should get all the rights which are attached to that title. Any other title holder, just like any other title holder, he must have all the rights to possess the property, enjoy the property, pay revenue, transfer, deal with mortgage, lease, whatever it is. All, anything can think of dealing with the immoral property. He can do it. Whether that does not matter whether he has perfected a title by adverse possession or whether he has purchased it. No matter. Law of adverse possession does not, paragraph 48, 50, 59. Paragraph 48, 50 and 59, please read. Law of adverse possession does not qualify only a defendant for the acquisition of title by adverse possession. See the point? It includes the plaintiff also. So a person who has perfected title by adverse possession can be the plaintiff also. Law of adverse possession does not qualify only a defendant for the acquisition of title by adverse possession. It may be perfected by a person who is filing a suit. Nothing wrong. It only restricts a right of the owner to possession before the period of limitation fixed for extinction of his right. Once right is extinguished, another person acquires title, prescriptive title, which cannot be defeated by re-entry. That also is held. A person in possession cannot be ousted by another person except by due procedure of law. and once 12 years period of adverse possession is over, even owner's right to eject him is lost, and the possessory owner acquires right, title and interest possessed by the outgoing person stroke owner. As the case may be, against whom he has prescribed. In our opinion, consequence is that once the right, title or interest is acquired, it can be used as a sword by the plaintiff as well as a shield by the defendant within the ken of Article 65 of the Act, and any person who has perfected title by way of adverse possession can file a suit for restoration of possession in case of dispossession. Then classic requirements of adverse possession: nec vi, nec clam, nec precario, pleading, how it should be made, tacking, that also in one of the episodes I have mentioned, and here also tacking can be dealt with as a separate subheading, and then we will come back to that. What is tacking and of those things? In short, it is, see, I am the owner. You trespassed upon my item of immoral property. You possessed for, say, 5 years with all the incidents of adverse possession, ingredients of adverse possession. Then you transferred whatever right you have got to X. X continued for 5 years. Then X transferred to Y. Y continued for another 5 years. Whether all these periods of 5 years, 5 years, 5 years can be put together so that the adverse possession total period 12 years is satisfied? Yes. They can tack on. There must be privity of contract, privity of, that relationship must be there. It is not the kinship that I am referring to, but an independent trespasser, suppose you have trespassed upon my property, after 5 years you were ousted by another man, then he possessed for 5 years, he was ousted by X, and X also continued for 5 years. All these 3-5 years period cannot be tacked on because you are all independent trespassers. There is no relationship with respect to property, no jural relationship, and independent rights are claimed. That cannot be tacked on. That also is mentioned. Then, in case of dispossession by another person by taking law in his hand, a possessory suit can be maintained under Article 64 by the adverse possessor, even before ripening of title by way of adverse possession. There, you must be very careful. See the expression used. In case of dispossession by another person, by taking law in his hand, a possessory suit can be maintained under Article 64 even before the ripening of title by way of adverse possession. I will give an example. I am the owner. You trespassed upon the property. You continued in adverse possession for 10 years. 2 more years is required to perfect title by adverse possession so that my rights will be extinguished under Section 27 of the Act. Then you will get title. 12 years have not come. And while so, you were dispossessed by X. You were dispossessed by X. What is your remedy against X? X is a stranger. There is no relationship with you so far as the property is concerned. Nothing. You can maintain a suit for possession under Article 64. Suit based on previous possession. Suit for possession based on previous possession. There the question is whether the plaintiff has proved possession. That possessory suit for possession based on possessory title cannot be filed against the true owner, namely me. So my property, you trespassed upon, you were dispossessed by X, you can file a suit under Article 64 against X. But I dispossess you. Can you file a suit under Article 64 based on dispossession? Previous possession? No. No such suit will be maintained, can be maintained against the true owner. Can you file a suit under Article 65 based on title? No. Because you have not perfected title by adverse possession. So your remedy is only under Section 6 of the Specific Relief Act. There also the consequences will follow. That is another person. In case of dispossession by another person, by taking law in his hand, a possessory suit can be maintained under Article 64 even before the ripening of title by way of adverse possession. Then suit can be filed, right to recover possession based on title, absolute, irrespective of limitation. We'll continue in the next episode, same Grewal's judgment. See you in the next episode. Thank you.